You know, people have been looking at eclipses for thousands of years, and sometimes those eclipses are right over their house. Sometimes those eclipses are halfway across the world. In the 18th, the 19th, 20th centuries, people increasingly started going on these scientific eclipse expeditions to view them. And the things that they brought with them could be pretty epic. We have a huge range of material at the library that documents exactly what eclipse expeditions packed when they went to see the totality. Here we have a photo album that was compiled during an eclipse expedition to coastal Africa, Angola, in 1889, on board a ship called the USS Pensacola. There were about a dozen scientists and researchers in different fields and hundreds of U.S. Navy sailors.
The accounts were there was 12 tons of astronomical equipment, and that's not considering the scientific instruments that they brought or the personal belongings.
That's right. There were other researchers doing other kinds of work. There were people that were collecting specimens for natural history collections, and they needed fluid to preserve the specimens. There were people that were doing magnetic observations, and they had pendulums and things like that.
They also loaded up housing, because where they were going, that you know, there were no hotels. And one thing that we noticed looking through all the photo albums and the reports and the letters is that there are no mentions of the eclipse. There are no photographs of the eclipse. There are no sketches of the eclipse. And that is because it was cloudy at that moment of totality.
Materials like this are still enormously useful.
And I feel like it's also important and valuable for the public and for kids, because it's a way to connect to history, and it's a way to connect with science as well.